I've been thinking about this video for a very long time, testing these for you. You are going to find out what the best drugstore dupe for the IT Cosmetics CC cream is. If that is your holy grail, you're gonna wanna stay tuned. Hi friends, this video came about because one of you said, why don't you do a comparison of all of the CC creams that are at the drugstore and then compare them to the IT CC cream and see which ones are best. So I have five that I picked up and I want to do that comparison for you right now. So we know that the gold standard is the IT CC cream. This has got skin loving ingredients in it. This one is the oil free matte one. I've also had the luminous one and the regular one. I like wearing light, but I also like wearing, I think there is a medium color. I'll make sure that I list that for you or put it up here in the summer. That's a really good color for me. This does have color correcting ingredients in it and skin loving ingredients in it. This one has an SPF of 40. The original has an SPF of 50. And I'm not exactly sure what the Illumination one has in it. It does have the SPF as well. It has the anti-aging ingredients in it. It is a hydrating serum and it boasts that it's a poreless full coverage finish. Okay, all of those things sound wonderful. And I can tell you that from my experience, I started wearing this probably 10 or 12 years ago. I can't remember when it was released, the original. I started wearing it. I loved it. I still love it. It's one of those ones that if I want the extra coverage with my foundation, I don't really rely on foundations for an SPF, but this one has a really good one in it. So I really do like it and the coverage is fantastic. So this one is the gold standard that we all have to live up to. And then I wanted to go ahead and try the ones at the drugstore. I have, like I said, five of these. I'm gonna start with what I least liked and then I'm going to go up. I actually am going to mention this one too. I got sent from Dermablend, their CC, their continuous correction. Again, SPF of 50. I did not like this one because it oxidized on me. Now, the thing about these ones is they do have a tendency to have that color correction in them, those little color correcting particles that are supposed to change and match your skin. And this one was just really bad about oxidation and breaking apart. So I want to go ahead and mention that one to you because Dermablend came out with this very recently and I know that a lot of people were talking about it and I just wanted to talk about that one. And then I'll also talk to you about the cream shop. I was at CVS and I got this one. This one is so orange and there are not many colors in it. This one is the light. It's super orange, it's super dark, and it just didn't work on me. It just was a patchy mess. So those two are just two that don't even belong in being recognized next to it because they don't really work the same way that can stand up to it. So let's start off with the e.l.f. Camo CC Cream. This one has an SPF of 40 in it. And again, it has the full coverage, natural finish, color correcting, collagen and peptides is what it says. This is too thick for my mature skin. And it just did not feel great going on my skin because I have texture, I have dark spots, I have all of those things that come with aging that this one just did not work for me. It was just too much of a foundation, too thick. You could probably very easily thin it down with a moisturizer or with a primer, but if there are others on the market that work better, that don't give me a strange color, I'm gonna go for those. So this is number five. This is at the bottom. This is one that I really wouldn't pick up. And then my next one is from Almay. This one is the Skin Perfecting Healthy Biome Makeup with Probiotic Complex. And this one says it nourishes, perfects, and protects as a broad spectrum SPF of 25, hypoallergenic and fragrance free. I do like that it's hypoallergenic and that it's fragrance free. The prebiotic complex that it talks about would be one that would be an antioxidant, protecting you from free radicals. That's really good. And of course the sunscreen is really good, even though it's pretty low at 25. I feel like it's still a fairly good sunscreen. Now, what I don't like about this is that it did oxidize on me very, very quickly. It got very orange. And again, there are not a lot of colors in this one either, so I don't feel like it was very inclusive. So this one is number four. It is not one that I would pick up again. It just didn't last a long time on my skin and just really was not one that I felt like I could go and say, yes, pick that up. Okay, my next one is from Maybelline, and this is the Dream Urban Cover. And this has an SPF of 50. This, again, says it's full coverage. And this one says that it's antioxidant enriched and that it's pollution protection. So again, they're looking at fighting those free radicals. The SPF on it, it looks like is a 40. I don't have my glasses over here. I don't know why I do that, but I don't have them over here. And Ollie is climbing behind me. Come on, buddy. You're just gonna sit there? Can you guys see him? You guys can't see him. Let me see. Ollie. he thinks he's gotta be in this chair with me. So this one is at the number three position because I feel like it's okay. It's not the greatest one that I've ever found. It's not the worst one that I've ever found. I do like that it does have the skin-loving ingredients in it. It does give very good coverage. My whole thing with this, and by the way, I'm wearing this on this side of my face today. My whole thing with this is that partway through the day, this is going to start to wear off. It doesn't wear off unevenly. It doesn't leave you with streaks or break apart. It's just that when you go to bed at night, you're not still going to have this on. It's going to have worn down. And that's kind of one of the things that I look for, especially in the heat, is that is it going to hold up for me all day long and not have any break apart? And again, it doesn't have the break apart, but it doesn't last. It has a great coverage and it really goes on easy. It doesn't change colors. It doesn't oxidize. It was a very pretty foundation and I do like it. And it even worked really well up underneath my eyes instead of concealer. I like that very much about it, but it's in that middle spot because it wore off so easily. All right, number two, this was really hard, but my number two is from L'Oreal, and this is the Age Perfect Radiant Serum Foundation with Sunscreen, a broad spectrum of 50 antioxidants concentrated serum. I have mine in Rose Ivory 15. This is a beautiful This is a beautiful color for me. I do have it on this side today. It is a very pretty foundation. It is a nice foundation as far as application. It goes on very smoothly. It goes on as a medium coverage, building up to full coverage with two coats really easily, and it covers all of my imperfections while still making my skin look like skin, and that's what I do like about it. I will say that this color is a little bit orange for me, so I did have to color correct it a bit. That's okay. Most foundations do that, but it didn't oxidize and go more orange, which is a very big bonus for me because obviously if you're already looking for a cool tone foundation, oxidation and going orange is a big no-no. You're not going to want that to happen throughout the day. So it didn't turn colors on me. It stayed true to its color. It covered, it lasted, and this was a very, very good one. And it's quite thin compared to like the e.l.f. The e.l.f. was so thick and it just didn't look like skin. I feel like this does look like skin. One thing is I do feel like it did kind of settle right around here in my chin and around my nose. I did have to powder it a little bit more than my number one choice, but this one, it's a really good one. And I can say that if you can't find the other one, this is a good substitute for it. It comes into a close second and I do like it very much. And I've been kind of trading off between these two. My number one, and this is probably not going to be any surprise because I love a number seven foundation. I have about five different foundations from this company, and I think they do foundations fantastically. And so when they came out with this, I actually was really excited and talked about it. Then they reached out to me and sent me another one. So I had two, which I was excited about because now I have my summer color and I have my winter color. This is the number seven Protect and Perfect Advanced All-in-One Foundation. This again has the sunscreen of 50 in it. It says hydrating, age-defying, medium coverage. And I really believe that that's true. It does have some fantastic ingredients in it that help with your aging. So you're getting the benefits of having a beautiful foundation right along with that sunscreen and some skincare in there too. I feel like this is every bit as beautiful coverage as the It CC Cream I absolutely love it. I actually think that I love it more. I have said that in past videos where I like this more than I like the ItCC. Not only do I like that the price point is a little bit better, but I actually like the way that this covers, the way that it looks on my mature skin. It doesn't show up any texture. It doesn't show up any fine lines. I get no break apart. It lasts all day. Yes, I do have to set this down with a setting spray, but especially in the summer. But the number 7 just kind of hits it out of the park and is so much more elevated above all of these other CC creams. And I can honestly say to you that this is the one that I would recommend if you came to me and said, I love the ItCC cream. What is the best one that dupes that is in the drugstore? 100% would I say that number 7 Protect and Perfect. It's just that good. It gives great coverage. It will dry down and so it will set down and be beautiful on your skin. If you're somebody that's very oily, you might want to look into a powder. And especially in the summer, you might want to touch up with a powder as well. I think it's wonderful. It ticks all the boxes for me. No texture, no oxidation, lasts a long time, no settling, no break apart. I think that it is just one of those that is wonderful and I can tout all day long. So of all of these, this is my favorite, including the It. This bumps above that just a little bit. And then you had the numbers of what the other ones were. The L'Oreal in a very, very close second, which I think would be just about a tie for the ItCC. But I wanted to make sure that I told you about that. I've had this video in the works for a long time and trying all of these for such a long time to be able to bring them to you, and I'm glad I got to do this video for you. Have you yourself found a dupe for the ItCC cream that you are in love with? I would like to hear that in the comment section below. I know that the Estee Lauder one is fantastic, but it is not exactly a dupe. It actually is the above one. I think that it's a great one. It has a little bit more of a dewy finish. If you are somebody that is very dry, you might want to look into that one. So thanks so much for spending a bit of your day with me. Hope everybody is doing well. Please take care of yourselves. I'll catch you all in my next video. Bye, my friends.